So here I'm going to show you how to shade your miniatures with a wash, a darker wash. And what I've done is with these harvesters, I spray painted them with copper, which is going to make them super easy to just add shading to it. But as you can see, just by spray painting, it's all one color. And what the shading will do, or what the wash will do, is fill the crevices in with darker colors, which will give it a natural shade that will be super easy. And then Colonel Scafford's gang, I spray painted white for a base, and then what I'm going to do now is just do block colors. So here you can see what I mean by block painting is putting in solid colors, the base colors of the miniatures that I will be washing with the darker color. And so that means for these guys, the Scafford gang, I basically have the basic colors that I want, and so all of this is going to become darker once we put the wash on. I am going to do something different with the skin. I'm not going to wash it with a dark black brown mixture, and I'll show you the redder color that I'm going to do for the skin. But first we'll be doing these figures, because basically they're all one color. This I spray painted this brown color, and then I painted the sides gray for the rocks. And this gateway, this portal, is mostly stone, and so I just spray painted it gray. So to make my mixture, basically I have my little container here, and what I do is I'm just using these cheap paints. Again, I use these, I don't use my more expensive paints, because you don't need the higher quality paints for your wash. So make sure you mix it up. And I have burnt umber and just black, basic black. And I add 2 drops of the burnt umber and 1 drop of black. And then this stuff here is Future Floor Wax. This you can buy from the cleaning supplies. And the important thing is that it has Future in it. So this is Pledge. I don't know if the bottle still looks like this. But the reason why you mix this in with it is because it will break up the surface tension so that the wash will sink into the crevices and cracks of your miniatures, and that's why you want that. And I went ahead and put it in a smaller bottle here so I could put drops in the mixture easily. So I put, oh, I don't know, about that much, about 5 or 6 drops in with that mixture. And then I take a big brush and I load it up with water, because I actually want water to be in there. And then I just mix the whole thing together like this. And I want it to be pretty watery. So once it's sort of where I want it to be, I go ahead and just apply the whole wash onto the figure. And in this case, it's the gate. And you can see that it's sinking in mostly into the crevices, and it will darken up the whole thing, but don't worry, we'll go back and paint over these sections once we're done. So I'll do the whole thing, even the ground, because what will happen is as it sinks down, it'll go into the cracks, and it basically provides shading in a really easy way. And there's a method called the dip method, where you actually dip your miniatures into actually wood stain. And the purpose behind that is basically to paint your models the way that you want it, and then you dip the whole thing so that your final step is actually having shading done for you, where you don't even go back and paint over the shading. When you do that, you have to put on really bright colors, because as you can see, putting on the wash does darken darken the model. So that is an option, and you can look online. I don't do that, but I know that a lot of people, it's a quick and easy way to do your miniatures. And then when you want it a little darker, you just add a little more paint. And it doesn't, once it dries, it will not be this dark. So just realize that drying, this figure will actually be lighter than what it's showing now when it's wet. So that's the gate. We'll go ahead and try one of these guys, one of the harvesters. And so again, just load up your brush and just glop it all on and have the thing sink in there a little deeper. Okay, so this wash is a little too brown for my tastes because the figure already is brown, so I'm going to add a little bit more black just to make it darker, maybe 2 drops. And that will require some more of the future polish. And this is acrylic. It's basically an acrylic clear coat. So all of these paints are acrylic based anyway. Just mix that up where it's primarily a little bit darker, more black. Mix it all together so that you have nice, okay. Yeah, see, that's significantly darker. And you're gonna go, oh my gosh, you're ruining the whole thing, you're covering up the whole thing. But trust me, this is how you get all the dark crevices the way that you want it. And if it is too thick, it's super easy. Just water down your brush and you can remove some of it. If you water your brush down a little bit, and you can sort of just remove. And you gotta be careful because this stuff does splatter around. So just removing, just dry your brush off, tap it in here, and then you can suck it up, suck up the parts where there's a little bit too much on there. There. So that looks pretty good. But as a way of comparison, see, this one hasn't been washed and this one has. And as you can tell, you know, you got the shading where the wash goes into the crevices and provides good shading. So that's what's happening behind the whole thing. And then now let me show you a wash for one of these guys. And I'm going to choose a smaller brush so that I have a little bit more control. And again, I'm going to do it around his clothes, but avoid his skin because the wash that I'm doing for his skin is different. And so basically, let's go around like this. And a lot of people do panic. They're like, oh my gosh, it's so dark. I'm ruining all the work that I did with my first layer of paint. You just gotta sort of trust that this is gonna give you the outline that you want and that you're looking for. And then make sure, oops, sorry, out of the camera. Make sure you get all the parts, the hat. And I will go ahead and do his face so that some of his facial features do pop out a little bit. See, I'll try to show you. See how some of the facial features pop out once I put this wash on. And so this is definitely my preferred method of shading. It's not the only way to do it, but for my purposes, it's one of the quickest. Now, of course, You don't need to do this at all. Once you put a solid coat of paint, you can stop right then and there. But I think providing shading for your models just makes it that much better. And because it's relatively easy, it's a good way just to give a little bit more punch to your miniatures. Get his axe here. Here. And that's pretty much it. And we just have to wait for it to dry. And then basically on his arms and his flesh, I want to put a red. So that looks sort of gnarly. I'll do that after. So that's pretty much it. That's how you provide washes for your miniatures, and I'll go ahead and do the rest of it and show you what it looks like. So here we have all of the washes that are dry, and you can notice here actually that this ended up being pretty dark and black, and that's because there wasn't enough future mixed in with it, so I actually got a darker sheen. It should look more like this. See this one here where the dark went deeper into the crevices and cracks, whereas this is sort of sitting on top. It doesn't really matter because I'm going to be painting over that anyway. But yeah, so these guys are all dry, and this is what the scaffold gang looks like. You notice that they're shading now on their clothes. Which is sort of the whole point of it, but I'll go through and go with the original reddish orange color over this to brighten up the highlights later. But right now I'm gonna do a wash. I continue to do washes, and there's a couple of washes that I need to do. You'll notice that anywhere that there's white, so these guys have white shirts on, this guy does too. I actually don't do the wash with the black and the brown because it's too dark. And I prefer to do a sort of a grayish bluish kind of wash. So I'll show you what that looks like. Paint plate here. Just need a little bit, not that much. And I got a smaller brush. And I go ahead and add a couple of drops of my future. Maybe just two drops for that amount. And then I load my brush up with water. And just mix that whole thing up. Yeah, and then I grab the figs with white and basically cover that up. And it might be a little bit too much blue, so I'm gonna take some of it off. And again, it's just sinking down into the cracks and crevices. And as you can see, if you scroll back in the video, when you first put the wash on, it's pretty dark, but it does lighten up. So here what I'm doing is I'll just take a little bit off so that more of the white shows through, like that. See how you have a little bit of control over how much of it gets on there. So that guy is done. So the blue is done. Also, there's this guy with yellow, sort of like a yellow shirt. And the black was too dark, so I'm just gonna use a lighter brown. I don't know what this is, chocolate or something. I could use one of my smaller bottles, my Reaper bottles, but it doesn't really matter. So I just need a tiny bit because it's just this one shirt. Add a couple drops of, I think one is enough probably. And using the same brush, water it down. I want to mix that up. A little bit more water. And then that's pretty watery. There you go. So after some time, you get used to what shading color works with various colors. So to shade sort of yellow, you use brown. To shade white, I use blue. Then in a moment, I'm going to use red for all the tentacles. But there, I think that looks good. And then I basically want the ends of the tentacles to be the most red. And so I'm going to start with the ends. And careful not to get it on the pickaxe. Basically, oops, I went ahead and got it on the handle. But I can paint over that later to fix that. Because I want the bottom part to be the most red, I sort of use it at full strength down here. But you can see sort of the pink coming through of the original paint. And then what I'm going to do is just take a little bit less and just put it, you know, the rest of the way here. Because I want there to be sort of a gradual flow of the color. But as you can see, you know, the character has these weird shapes here as well. So that's basically how I want it to look. See how it now, with that red, it looks more, I don't know, fleshy or gnarly. And that's why I want to do a red wash like that. Make it look appropriately gross. Here is the kernel. I'm going to do basically his legs all in this color. Make it look particularly gross and mute. Is that a word? Not mutiny, but like a mutant. I don't know what adjective to use to describe that. But yeah. See how I naturally got lighter because I lost or used up a lot of the paint down here, which helps it, you know, go from, have a faded look from light to dark. And again, when this dries, it will dry significantly lighter than what you see, so you just need to be mindful of that.
Yeah, I had the most amazing day ever. I said, wow, it was so good that Miss Hefner brought us donuts this morning. She was going to give us brownies, but she ran out of time to make them, so she got us donuts.
That is amazing. So here I'll actually add a little bit more red down here towards the ends. Like this, just to make the red a little stronger. Again, towards the end of the tentacles and the mutated parts of the body. Here's a spot that needs some color. I think that's it. But yeah. Sort of how all of this shading stuff works. See? It looks appropriately gross. Alright, so this is what they look like, dry. So I think they turned out pretty well. Where you have being a little bit more red towards the ends. And at this point, you can actually stop here and be done with it, but I'll go ahead and show you what to do to sort of blend, because here you'll see that the face has that darker black and brown wash on it, and then the rest of the body, it doesn't really flow together. So what I'm going to do is just touch it up with some paint. And this is the original color that I use, which is a little bit darker. And I'll just go one step lighter than that. And if you don't have that, just add white to this and you get the same color. But normally I think if this was a hero figure, I would go ahead and go back through, lighten up, you know, dry brush the black and the brown, but because this is one of the enemy figures, I think I'll just do the skin and be done with it. So as you can see, I only use a little bit of paint, doesn't take a whole lot. Use a small brush. And so basically, I want to just touch up the face and then areas around the body. But my brush is a little bit too wet. So I just want to highlight the face a little. And just lighten up here around the body. So that it, sorry, it's not focusing very well. But the upper part is where I want to lighten it up a little. And then have it flow into the lower part, where his tentacles are more red. But what this will do is just provide a little bit more continuity between the head and the rest of the body. So see how the highlights, where the dry brushing is only touching up the high points of the model. And gotta do it on the back as well, although the back is a pretty good sort of flow to it already of color. Going from this lighter to this darker red to more of a red. And then I do want to touch up on the hand, which I didn't put any of the red on, but just keep it flesh colored that way. Maybe a little bit more here. See, that looks pretty cool, right? Okay, so here I am outside in my garage. So I did decide to go ahead and try to lighten these up a little bit. The lighting in my garage is really bad, and I do have my garage door open. Now the thing is I don't have any bottled paint that's this color, because I use this spray paint for it, this copper. So the way that you get around that is I just have one of these throwaway brushes that I trimmed down a little bit, because I don't want it to be that big. And all you have to do is just spray some of this onto a plate or something like that, so that you get enough like that. And then you just use it like this. And I don't have to tell you why you have to do this in a well-ventilated area outside. See if you can see this. It is lightening it up a little bit, but I don't know if you can tell, since the lighting is so bad out here right now. So I'm just dragging the paint down and highlighting. So this is pretty much the same as dry brushing. I'm just hitting the highlighted spots. Over here, I have sprayed these with Dull Coat. Tester's Dull Coat. I know it comes in a little bottle, but I've tried a ton of other matte sprays, and none of them really work that well. They end up being satin if you put too much on, and Dull Coat I found to be the best brand. So let me show you how to go ahead and brush after putting the wash on these. You're going to dry brush a lighter gray on there. And so first I tried this gray, but it was too dark. It was too similar to the base coat. So I'm going to go with a lighter gray here. And you want to use the dry brush technique, which you put a little bit on there, and then you rub so that there's only a little bit remaining on your brush. And then with that, you're going to hit the highlights like this, like so. And you're dragging it across here so that the paint isn't going into the crevices, only on the surface. And this is pretty much what dry brushing is highlighting sort of all the parts that stick out. And I want to do that with the ground as well. Oops, see what happens when it's too wet? But that's okay, you can just rub it out like that. If you get too much of a glob on there, flip it over and do the other side. Like so. See how easy that is? Not hard at all. And get the sides as well here. Ground. And that's pretty much how you highlight. I'll wait and see after this dries whether or not I want to go even lighter, or I add some white and lighten this up even more. But let me show you a comparison between the two. So this one's a little bit lighter. It's harder to tell here. Wait, let me see, maybe this one. Yeah, between these two you can sort of tell. And I'll go ahead and do these gates as well, since we have stone on the sides. Same thing. Dry off your brush and then sort of just hit the highlights like that. Done. Yeah. So I'll show you a comparison. And this time I'm using a smaller bristle brush, just so that I have more control, since I have to navigate around here and not get the stone. So I don't wet my brush first with water. Let me see if you can see that. Before I dry it off. And then basically just cover this floor up with this brown. Might have to do two coats just to get it to cover up, because the color difference, this is pretty dark. And this brown color is such that I might not be able to get the color that I want after just one pass. But because I'm going to be highlighting with another coat, I can press this in pretty deep, like that. And I go ahead and color the skulls this color too. Skulls that are down in here. Because I'll come back later with white, or beige, not white, but beige. There, so that's pretty good. I want to show you something. I'm going to go ahead and do a second coat because the color doesn't seem bright enough to me. And you can tell just by doing a second coat, it brightens it up a lot. So this is a highlight color. I actually don't bother to rinse my brush in between because the paint is pretty much, the old paint is dry. So I put it in there and brush it off and grab this and again, just drag it across. Not enough paint. That establishes some highlights. So one of the things you'll notice on the painting guide, Shadows of Brimstone painting guide, is that it has sort of like a turquoise down here, which I like. So I'm just going to mix these two colors together to get sort of a grayish, bluish tone. I guess I could add green to it to make it more turquoisey, but I'm too lazy. I'll just make a color like this. I don't want it to be too strong of a blue. And then take some of it off. And then apply it here really lightly. See some of the color rubbing off on the bottom along here. Pretty similar, so I'll do that to the rest of them. Okay, so I'm seeing a problem here. I followed the paint scheme that was in the painting suggestion from Shadows of Brimstone, but because I strayed and made his tentacles red, I think his shirt blends in too much with his tentacles and it doesn't contrast enough, so I'm going to actually paint over his shirt and make it dark green. So I'm not going to be doing a wash for this color, and instead I'm painting the darkest color that I want, and then we'll lighten up the green in different several layers in order to do highlighting. I could, if I put a lighter green, I could do a wash, but this is quicker, so I'm choosing this method instead. Painting and highlighting his shirt. So it's green now. So I think that's a lot better for contrast. So, and I finished up these harvesters. These were super simple. I just painted black sort of in these crevices, these tubes that are there, and then highlighted with gray. And then just put green on these dots and then put yellow in the center of them. So these guys, super simple, right? So the next step is really basing, and you can just keep them painted brown like this. I paint all the bases sort of a brown, chocolate brown, and then I glue these guys on there. And then when I was putting the wash, some of the wash gets on there, but that's fine, right? It provides some natural shading. But a simple way for me to base is to put gravel on, as well as some static grass. And so I use the same static grass and gravel for all of the monsters, and then the heroes have actually a lighter gravel. And this is just gravel that you get from the hobby shop in the train section, the train section, and they sell bags of this, so this will last me forever. And what I do is I just take my super glue, and you can use Elmer's glue too, but I put the gravel on first. Oh, make sure that you spray your protective coating on these before you do flocking, just because the grass will just get messed up by your protective spray. So the first thing I do is just create a random pattern with my super glue on here, and then I'll use a toothpick to sort of spread it around. And just do that, and if I can see where I put my toothpick. And then I use this to sort of just spread it around fairly close to the edge to where I want it. And then once I'm done with that. Very simple to just dip it in here like this. And you just tap off the excess. And voila, that's it. And the reason why I use super glue for the gravel is because I'm going to, here, I'll show you a harvester, because I want to be able to put the static grass on, and I actually use Elmer's glue, Elmer's white glue, for the grass, because the grass has a tendency to soak up the super glue, and I don't want it to do that. So that's the reason why I use super glue for the gravel, and then white Elmer's glue for the static grass. And of course the Elmer's glue is going to take a lot longer to dry, so that's why I do the gravel first, because almost immediately you're able to do the gravel or the grass, the flocking, after you do this. And I'll show you, because by the time I'm done with this guy, this super glue on the Scafford Gang member will be done. So yeah. And the reason why I paint the base brown is in case you're able to see through the grass towards the bottom. And that's why I provide a coat of brown paint rather than leaving it black. So this guy, it's dry already. So I'll show you how to do flocking. So let me get this out of the way and replace it with the grass. And you can get all kinds of colors of grass. And so basically I just stick some white glue in the remaining open spots that doesn't have gravel on it. And then again, I take my toothpick and I even it out, I spread it out. And the key to this is to not get it on the miniature nor over the lip of the base. Let me flip this around. Let's see, I got a little bit there on the lip. So what I'm going to do is just wipe it off with my thumb. And then once I got all the spots that I want, I just dip it in here and make sure that I get plenty of grass. And then I just flip it upside down and I tap it my finger like this to knock off any of the loose stuff. And then see how it's hanging over the edge? I think it looks sort of messy that way, so I actually push it up before it dries. But that's personal preference, whether you want it hanging over the edge or not. There are static grass applicators sort of that are charged statically so that the grass stands up when you glue it, but I think this is fine. So there you go. So I'm going to do that to the rest of the models. So here are the finished pieces. The harvesters here. They were pretty simple to make. Paint, very simple. We have the doors, which I think turned out pretty well. And the Scafford Gang. And I'm glad that I changed the color. That green ended up looking more bluish, which I'm fine with. But the contrast is a lot better with the shirt being a different color. And as you can see, the fading is pretty good on the skin tones. So I'm happy about that.
And then I'll just show you these undead fighters. This is a different method of shading where you spray paint the base coat black and then you just paint over it. And as you can tell the difference between the undead fighters and the scaffold gang, where this guy is a lot lighter. And so this method actually, even though it takes longer because you're doing two additional coats because of the wash, it actually has more subtlety in coloring versus when you go black and then just layer it. This method is a lot faster. And so usually with pieces that I want to really get done quickly, I'll use a black spray paint. But look at the Serpent Men here. I did a wash with them and you can tell that the colors are a lot more subtle with them versus when you do a black spray paint. Here, I'll show you over here too. Here's the one I'm doing undead. I like these guys. This is Zombicide where I have to make, there's tons of these figures. So I'm trying to crank these out as fast as possible, but I spray painted all these guys black first. And you can achieve a good level of shading with these guys, but it's really for the sake of speed that I spray painted these guys, even the heroes, black, because I wanted to get them done as quickly as possible rather than doing a wash with them. So that's it, and hopefully that was helpful for you.